गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन आई एम संपूर्ण लक्ष्मी वर्किंग एज बायोलॉजिकल साइंस टीचर चिलकलूरपेट केजीबीवी गुंटूर डिस्ट्रिक्ट
गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन आई एम संपूर्ण लक्ष्मी वर्किंग एज बायोलॉजिकल साइंस टीचर चिलकलूरपेट गुंटूर डिस्ट्रिक्ट टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एनवायरमेंटल एजुकेशन Today our topic is diseases in plants. Here viral diseases in some plants are today we are discussing. They are tobacco mosaic virus in tobacco and second one tomato spotted wilt plant virus and third one tomato yellow leaf curl virus and fourth one cucumber mosaic virus. So these are today you are learn. Tobacco mosaic virus in tobacco plant. What are the symptoms? Stunning the plant, that means the plant is not growing properly. Mosaic pattern of light and dark green or yellow green on the leaves. Dark green, light yellow green, mosaic patterns of these different color we are observe on the leaves. Malformation of leaves or growing points. Yellow streaking of leaves. These yellow streaking of leaves you are observe in only monocots. Yellow spotting on leaves. When you are observe the leaves of tobacco mosaic virus in tobacco plant, then yellow colored spots observed. Distinct yellowing of veins only. The veins also yellowing. These are the symptoms of the tobacco mosaic virus in tobacco plant. Next. Tobacco mosaic virus is transmitted how? The TMV is very easily transmitted when an infected leaf rubs against a leaf of a healthy plant. TMV is transmitted. One infected plant is taken and rubbed with the healthy plant. Immediately the disease is transmitted from infected plant to healthy plant by contaminated tools and occasionally by workers. When the tools are contaminated with the infected leaves or disease and workers also, their hands also contaminate with the after smoking cigarettes, the TMV is transmitted immediately. The virus can also contaminate seed coats. And the plants germinate from these seeds can become infected. A wounded plant cell provides a site of entry for TMV. The plant any part wounded, so this is the site for entry of the TMV. So these wounded places used to entry of tobacco mosaic virus in the plant. How to prevent the tobacco mosaic virus in the crop field? When starting the crop, purchase virus free plants and planting the virus free plants of tobacco. Next, after some days, the weeds are growing in the crop field. These weeds are removed immediately. Next, symptoms observed plants remove from the plant and set aside. And when the symptoms observed plants discard or infected plants discard from the crop field. Then observe the leaf of the tobacco. So here spots observed on the tobacco leaves. So here also observe spots observed on the tobacco leaf, and other pictures are tobacco plant and the leaves. So in this way you learn tobacco mosaic virus symptoms, transmission and prevention. Next disease is tomato spotted wilt virus. Symptoms of tomato spotted wilt virus. Plants infected with tomato spotted wilt virus exhibit bronzing of upper sides of young leaves, which later develop distinct necrotic spots. Leaves may be cupped downward. Some tip dieback may occur. On ripe fruit, chlorotic spots and blotches appear, often when concentric rings. So these are the chlorotic spots and concentric rings appear on the ripe tomato fruit. These are the necrotic spots. So here on the fruit, concentric rings observed. And these are the tips of the leaves dyed. And these are called necrotic spots. What is necrotic? Necrotic means the cell's part is dyed. Then after dyed the cell part, it is appear look like these spots structure. So these are called necrotic spots. These are the symptoms of the tomato spotted wilt virus. Next, transmission. How the tomato wilt virus is transmitted? Tomato wilt virus is transmitted by the thrips vector. What is the meaning of thrips here? Thrips means small sucking insects in the plant. From the plants, small insects sucking the juice. So these are called thrips. Prevention. How to prevent the transmission? Avoid planting near crops infected with tomato spotted wilt virus. When any healthy plant is planting time, observe any infected plant is near that place, immediately stop the planting. Monitor or observe thrips and symptoms. If thrips are present and symptoms are observed, manage thrips to minimize the spread of the virus in the field. So when symptoms observed, immediately minimize the spread of the virus to manage the symptoms after observation. Remove the infected plants from the crop field. When observe the symptoms of the plants or infected plants, immediately remove the plants from the crop field. So in this way you learn symptoms of the tomato spotted wilt virus, transmission and prevention. Next disease, tomato yellow leaf curl virus. Symptoms of the tomato yellow leaf curl virus are in tomato plants are the upward curling of leaves. Look at in the picture, these leaves are upward curling in the leaves. Yellowing on the edges of the leaves. Smaller leaves than normal. So here observe the leaves are small in size when compared to the normal leaf size. And these are the edges of the leaf are yellow in color. And the flowers dropped when the crop field is caused by the disease, then the flowers dropped. So here observe no any flower. So there is no flower, there is no fruit also. So fruits also not present in the crop field of tomato. So one or two only observe here. Infected plants may appear randomly throughout the garden. So any infected plant we are observe. So that is present in the garden randomly we are observe. Pepper plants may also become infected but will show no symptoms. Tomato and pepper plants both infected by the disease, then pepper plants not show the symptoms. Next, transmission. Tomato yellow leaf curl virus is transmitted by white flies. Through white flies, tomato yellow leaf curl virus transmitted from one plant to the other plant. This disease is extremely damaging to fruit yield in tomato and pepper crop. Tomato and pepper both crops are infected or damaged by the fruit stage. White flies may bring the disease into the garden from infected weeds nearby, such as various nightshades and Jimson weed. So white flies cause the disease. Tomatoes may not show signs of infection for as long as 2 to 3 weeks. After disease causing 2 to 3 weeks, the symptoms appear on the crop plants. Next, prevention. Removal of plants with initial symptoms may slow the spread of the disease. So immediately remove the infected plants from the crop field to control the spread of the disease. Any plant that you pull out that are infected plants should be immediately bagged to prevent the spread of the white flies feeding on those plants. So any plant pull out from the crop field, it is immediately bagged because to prevent the spread of the disease from one plant to the other healthy plants. Keep weeds controlled within and around the garden site, as these may be alternate hosts for white flies. So immediately remove the weeds from the crop field. Preventive mulches can be used in the rows to reduce white fly feeding. So calcium or silver colored mulches are used to prevent the tomato leaf curl virus in the crop field. Cucumber mosaic virus. Symptoms of cucumber mosaic virus: stunning, stop growing the plant, mosaic pattern of light and dark green or yellow and green on the leaves, malformation of leaves or growing points, yellow streaking of leaves. So the leaves are yellow streaking and dark green, light green and light yellow color observed on the leaves. Ring spots or line patterns on leaves or fruit. Lines or ring spots on fruits are observed on cucumber fruits. Flower color breaking. So here flower color also breaking. Look at, these are the symptoms of the cucumber we are observe on the fruits and leaves. Transmission and prevention. Transmission. Cucumber mosaic virus is transmitted from plant to plant both mechanically by sap and by aphids. Through aphids and mechanically by sap, the disease is transmitted from plant to plant. How to prevent the disease? Prevention. Purchase virus-free plants starting the crop planting, virus free plants are purchased and these plants are used in the crop field. Maintain strict aphid control. So always control the aphids. Remove all weeds. After some days the weeds are growing middle of the crop plants. Those are immediately removed. Discard virus infected plants. Observe the virus infected plants, immediately discard. Disinfect tools used for vegetative propagation frequently. The tools are used disinfect always when needed to the vegetative propagation. Next, little leaf of brinjal. Symptoms of little leaf of brinjal. Leaves and plants become small. Children, here look at, leaves are small in size and plant in small size. Node and internodes reduce in size. Leaves get yellowing. Look at here, leaves are yellow in color. Plants look like a bush. No fruiting. Little leaf of brinjal causing crop field not producing fruits if they become small and hard. These pictures observe. So here small size leaves and plant look like a bush and small in size. Next, transmission and prevention. Transmission. Little leaf of brinjal is transmitted by the insect vector Hishimonas physetes. This Hishimonas physetes belongs to the group of leaf hoppers. Through Hishimonas physetes, little leaf of brinjal is transmitted through insect vector. Prevention. Remove infected plants and destroy them. When observe the infected plants in the crop fields, they are immediately remove and destroy them. Before transplantation, dip the seedlings in 0.2% carbofuran 50 STD solution to control insect vector. Spray with dimethoate 0.3%. In this way, this type of preventive measures used in the crop field then to control the little leaf of brinjal. Next disease, leaf curl of papaya. Symptoms of leaf curl of papaya. Curling, wrinkling and distortion of leaves. Observe in the papaya plant and leaves. Reduction of leaf lamina, rolling of leaf margins inward and downwards and thickening of veins. Observe here, veins are thickening. Leaves become leathery, brittle and destroyed. Plants stunned. Look at here, the plant is stunned. That means the plant is not growing properly. Affected plants does not produce flowers or fruits. Look at the picture. The stunned plant not produce flowers or fruits. Next, transmission and prevention in papaya. Transmission. Papaya leaf curl virus is Gemini virus group. So this papaya leaf curl virus is belongs to Gemini virus group. It is transmitted by white flies under natural conditions. So here, when natural conditions are there, white flies are transmitted. And this is also transmitted from one plant to the other plant through white flies in natural conditions. How to prevent this disease? As soon as the disease symptoms are observed, dusting sulfur 30 grams per 10 liters of water, spraying Calixin 75 EC 5 ml per 10 liters of water. These two are used in the crop field at a 15 days interval, help to control the disease. Now we are discussing about the bacterial diseases in plants. They are ring rot of potato, black rot of mustard, bacterial canker in lemon. Ring rot of potato. Symptoms of ring rot of potato. Infected plants usually do not show above ground symptoms until they are fully grown. So the plants infected by the disease, the symptoms are not observed. The plant is after growing full. The symptoms occur late in the season. The leaves then begin to wilt, containing until all the leaves of stem wilt and the stem then dies. So after the wilt begins, after some days the stem also dies. If wilted stem is cut at the base and is squeezed, creamy liquid oozes out of the vascular bundle. When the disease causing stem or wilted stem is cutting at the base place, squeezed creamy liquid type of material oozes out of the cutting place, oozes out of the vascular bundles. The disease also affects one or more tubers of each plant. So one above the other tubers also affected by the disease. Internal areas of its leaflets turn yellowish and the leaf margins roll upward, become the leaflets turn yellowish. The yellow color is changed the leaf margins and leaf margins roll upward. So look at here, the leaf margins are upward and yellow colored margins you are observed. So and it is potato. This is causing potato, this one. So look at here, plants also died after wilt. Look at here, some plants are healthy and some plants are dried condition. So it is the disease causing potato, and the potato is cutting into pieces. The creamy layer like structure observed into the potato piece. So it is also another potato disease causing one. Next, transmission and prevention. Bacteria are spread easily by knives used to cut potato seed pieces. When the potato disease causing potato is cut by the knife, this type of knife is used to cut the another potato pieces. then immediately the disease spread from one to another potatoes. A knife used to cut an infected tuber may infect the next 20 healthy pieces cut with it. So how many potatoes damaged here? 20 potatoes damaged by the disease. Bacteria enters into the plants only through wounds and invade the xylem vessels in which they multiply profusely and may cause plugging. The bacteria enters through the wounds of the plant. Bacteria also move out of the xylem vessels into the surrounding parenchyma tissues, which they break down and cause cavities, and then again into new vessels. So in this way, xylem vessels surrounded in parenchyma tissues, and other new tissues also again has the cavities. So bacteria also invade the roots and cause them to deteriorate. So in this way, the disease transmitted from the one plant to other new healthy plant. Next, prevention. Potato ringrot is controlled through the use of healthy seed tubers. When the planting time, the healthy potato tubers are used. So it is the best prevention method to control the transmission of the disease in potato. Another disease, black rot of mustard. Symptoms of the black rot of mustard: dark colored streaks are formed on the stem from the ground level gradually. So the disease is starting from the ground level to grow the entire plant. These streaks enlarge and girdle the stem. So slowly the streaks are passed to the entire the stem. Stem become hollow due to the internal rooting. So the stem internal part is rooting, then it is changed into hollow structure. Midrib cracking of lower leaves, burrowing of veins and withering is observed. The midrib is cracked in lower leaves and burrowing of veins and withering is observed in the plant. The veins show brown to black discoloration. Veins also, when observed, it changed brown to black color. So look at here. So here, observe the symptoms on the leaves. Look at here. So the brown to black coloration observed on the leaves. Here, these are the symptoms of the disease. Next, transmission and prevention. Transmission. The pathogen thrives in warm, wet weather, spreading from plant to plant by splashing water, wind-blown water droplets, and by workers or animals moving from infected fields to healthy fields. In warm and wet weather, is used to pathogen transmitted from infected plant to healthy plants of the crop field. And wind-blown water droplets and workers and animals moving from infected fields to healthy fields also the disease is transmitted. Prevention. Start with clean seeds in warm, humid weather. So the clean seeds starting using in warm and humid weather. A single infected seed is as many as 10,000 could lead to black rot outbreak. Only one single infected seed is used to 10,000 could lead to blackout break. So we prevent carefully the disease control methods. Next disease is bacterial canker in lemon. Symptoms of the bacterial canker in lemon. Plants infected with citrus canker have characteristic lesions on leaves, stem and fruits with raised brown water soaked margins. So citrus canker affected leaves, stem and fruits are raised and brown watery soaked margins observed on these parts of the plant, those leaves, stem and fruits. So you are observed, these are the soaked watery margins on the fruits and leaves. So these are the symptoms observed on the leaves and fruits of the lemon. Usually with a yellow halo or ring effect around the lesion. So ring like structures also observed on the fruits and leaf also. Older lesions have a cracky appearance, still in many cases retaining the halo effect. So you are observe the symptoms on the fruits look like the ring like structures and brown color structures on the leaves and the fruits of the lemon. Next, treatment and prevention. Disease management is the only way. Treatment and prevention. Disease management is the only way to control the disease. Citrus canker management involves the use of the timely applications of copper containing products and windbreaks to hinder in column dispersal. So here citrus canker, how to transmit copper containing products also and windbreaks to hinder in column dispersal. Next, prevention. Prevention is the best option to protect against citrus canker. So when we follow the preventive measures, then it is the best method to control the citrus canker disease. Canker causes the citrus tree to continuous decline in health and fruit production until the products no fruit at all. So canker causes the citrus tree to stop the fruit production. Citrus canker is highly contagious and can be spread rapidly. So it is spread rapidly from one plant to the other and enter the crop field. Next disease, black rot of cauliflower. Symptoms of black rot of cauliflower. Symptoms on cauliflower often appear black flecks or scorched leaf margins. The cuds of infected cauliflower heads often become blackened. Black rot symptoms appear as dead tissue at the tips of cauliflower and cabbage leaves. Like this. This is the cauliflower. Black rot of cauliflower in cauliflower. This is cabbage. This is the black rot of cabbage. Transmission of black rot of cabbage. The black rot bacteria can also infect and survive on many cruciferous weeds. Black rot of bacteria transmitted through cruciferous weeds. The pathogen spreads very quickly when rain droplets contaminated with bacteria splash onto healthy leaves. Through water droplets of rain, the black rot of bacteria contaminated to healthy leaves. The bacteria move into the leaf veins. Through the leaf veins, the bacteria move from infected plant to healthy plant. Next, prevention of black rot of cauliflower, cabbage. For cabbage and Brussels sprouts, soak seed for 25 minutes in 122 degrees Fahrenheit of water. For Chinese cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower and turnip, soak for 20 minutes in 122 degrees Fahrenheit water. In this way, prevent the black rot of cabbage, cauliflower, broccoli, etc. Next, leaf blight in rice disease. Symptoms of leaf blight in rice: wilting and yellowing of leaves. Look at here, the leaves are wilting and yellowing. Wilting of seedlings: infected leaves turn grayish green and roll up. As the disease progresses, the leaves turn yellow to straw colored and wilt, leading whole seedlings to dry up and die. Transmission: bacteria travel through the water from infected plants to the roots and leaves of neighboring rice plants through water and plants. Roots, leaves of neighboring rice plants are infected by the bacteria. Wind and water may also help spread bacteria to other crops and rice paddies. Water and wind also help to transmit the bacteria from one plant to the other plant in the crop field. Prevention: how to prevent this disease? Keep field clean always. Always the crop field cleaning. Remove weeds host. Always remove the weeds grown after. And plow or plug under rice stubble. Here stubble means cut stalks of cereal plants. Straw, rice, rattans and volunteer seedlings, which can serve as host of bacteria. So, remove weed host and plug under rice stubble. Straw, rice, rattans and volunteer seedlings are removed from the field. So, these can serve as hosts of bacteria. Allow fallow fields to dry in order to suppress disease agents in the soil and plant residues. So the plant's residues also contain the disease agents. So these are the prevention measures to control the disease. Next disease is bacterial canker in capsicum. Symptoms of bacterial canker in capsicum. Symptoms of bacterial canker appear on leaf and fruit spots and less frequently. Systematic wilt. Fruits, leaves, spores appear in localized infection systems. First appear as small blisters or raised white spots on leaves and stems. Observe the spots on the leaves and stems. Later, the centers of the leaf spots become brown and necrotic and develop white halo. Look at here, this is the capsicum fruit, then it is the capsicum leaf. Observe the symptoms of the leaf spots, observe, and the spots observe on the fruit also. So later, the centers of the leaf spots become brown and necrotic and develop a white halo. Look at, these are the necrotic spots on the leaf of capsicum. Next, transmission. The bacterium enters the plant via wounds and stomata. The bacterium transmitted from plant to the plant via wounds and stomata. Clavibacter may be seed borne and may infect the seed externally or under the seed coat. Clavibacter may be seed borne. So this bacterium caused by Clavibacter, so it is a seed borne bacteria and infect the seeds externally or outside or under the seed coat. High relative humidity and daytime temperatures between 25 to 30 degrees generally favor the disease. So generally 25 to 30 degrees temperatures are used to transmit the disease. Insects, tools and human contact may also aid the spread through the tools. Through insects, human contact transmit the disease from the crop field. Next, prevention. How to prevent the disease? Sow only tested seed under certified transplants. When the seeds sowing before, test the seeds are used or certified transplants are used. Do not transplant capsicum or pepper into ground. Ground used tomatoes during the previous season. So do not transplant capsicum or pepper into ground used for tomatoes during the previous season. Previous season, ground used tomatoes are not used to transplant the capsicum. Clean equipment before entering a new fields. When foliage, that means plant leaves, is wet and incorporate, means contain plant debris immediately after harvest to help reduce losses. Clean cultivation equipment before entering a new fields. When plant leaves wet and incorporate plant debris immediately. So after harvest to help reduce losses. So these are the preventive measures in capsicum. So symptoms. Look at the symptoms on the capsicum fruit. Spots observed. Necrotic spots observe on the leaf, transmission and prevention. Now after completion of the topics, I gave some questions in assignment. What are the symptoms you are observed in tobacco mosaic virus? Which disease is transmitted by white flies? Where was observed chlorotic spots and concentric rings? What is the meaning of stunning? Write the preventive measures of black rot mustard. Write the symptoms in bacterial canker in lemon. What are the preventive measures of black rot of cauliflower?